to break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today.
It is Thursday, December 7th, 2023. My name is Brody. Happy birthday to Jaylen in Miss Monaghan's room and RBP in Miss Cook's room. Today is National Cotton Candy Day. Did you know that a dentist and a candy maker are credited for the invention of the machine spun candy? It was introduced to a wide audience at the World's Fair in 1904. I wonder if you'll eat cotton candy today. Bye!
Our big idea is generosity. Often we think of generosity in terms of gift-giving or volunteering, but generosity can also be a spontaneous part of your day. It's always good to look for little ways to make a positive difference in someone's day, like pitching in to help with a sibling's chores, or being kind to someone after they've made a mistake. Words of affirmation can be a powerful way to show generosity. When we choose to praise others who are generous, we are setting a standard for praiseworthy behavior. Generosity is the desire to give what you have to others. Generous people are not selfish. They want to help those in need and are always willing to share.
Today in history, December 7th, 1941, the bombing of Pearl Harbor. At 7:55 a.m., Hawaii time, a Japanese dive bomber bearing the red symbol of the rising sun of Japan on his wings appears out of clouds above the island of Oahu. A swarm of 360 Japanese warplanes followed, descending on the United States Naval Base at Pearl Harbor in a ferocious assault. The surprise attack struck a critical blow against the United States Pacific Fleet and drew the United States into World War II. With diplomatic negotiations with Japan breaking down, the United States knew that an imminent Japanese attack was probable, but nothing had been done to increase security at the important naval base at Pearl Harbor. Most of the Pacific Fleet was rendered useless. Five of eight battleships, three destroyers, and seven other ships were sunk or severely damaged, and more than 200 aircraft were destroyed. A total of 2,400 Americans were killed and 1,200 were wounded, many while valiantly attempting to repulse the attack. Japan's losses were only some 30 planes. The day after Pearl Harbor was bombed, President Roosevelt appeared before a joint session of Congress and declared yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a day which will live in infamy. The United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. After a brief and forceful speech, he asked Congress to approve the resolution recognizing the state of war between the United States and the country of Japan. The Senate voted for war against Japan by 82-0, and the House of Representatives approved the resolution by a vote 388-1. The American contribution to the successful Allied war effort spanned four long years and cost more than 400,000 American lives.
Hey, Bearsall, we want to go ahead and end our announcements this morning, but before we do, we want to go ahead and run through our STAR expectations.
Strive to do your best.
Take responsibility for your actions.
Always be safe.
Respect people and property. At this time, we ask all students and staff to rise for the national anthem, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance. And we hope everyone has a wonderful day at Bearsville Elementary.